ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. She saw my eyes, she know I'm gone. I see some things that you might fear. I'm doing a show, I'll be back soon. That ain't what she wanna hear. Now I got it in my room.
Yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Here's Flacco off the play fake to Lindsey. Now a hit and Flacco drops the football. It's loose. And the Raiders pick it up. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
Well, that's a down and distance coach is always talking about trying to avoid, isn't it? I mean, that's third and long. And you just know they're pinning their ears back and coming after him. Sometimes even with extra pressure.
And he knew that. I mean,
they fake the handoff. Now Flacco to pass. He'll get this to Philip Lindsay complete. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. And this is a guy straight out of college. They're not going to try to groom for a year or two. They want him to produce right away.
That's why they took him in the first round. They expect him to be a starter right away and a future all-pro. So they don't have any time to wait for him to come along. They want him to play right now to help this team.
And you take a look at his draft class from a season ago. Really, it grades out as a pretty darn good class.
They have to give a lot of credit to the entire scouting organization.
And this rivalry also stands as the most common pairing for Monday night games like we have here 18 times, the most of any two teams. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to...
First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. Got a man open, it's Sutton. And they worked this well upfield across the 45.
Here we go, here we go.
The end result. Now the Notre Dame man, this is Theo Riddick. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Riddick. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the third. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Flacco throws complete to Sutton. And they'll bring him down at the 8. Flacco leaves to Lindsay on the draw. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll look to run with Freeman. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out as his guys are back within a single score.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that in.
He's checking.
They'll start on the ground with Lindsay. Give him 14 yards there and a Denver first down. What an issue for them in this game. From the 45 on second down, Flacco. And that is incomplete. Well, that's successful.
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. 17 yards here on third down following two negative plays. Flacco from the gun. Finding the open man, and that's Tim Patrick. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Tim Patrick, 46 yards, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice session.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Flacco. He completes this to Sutton. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 30. Still a 39 on second and 10. Now it's Flacco. Got a man. That's complete to Hamilton. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 35.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arc on it, he's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football. They really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They struggle to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. Now on fourth down here, that pass knocked away and incomplete. So the failure to convert, no doubt, really hurts. But this one's not over. Good chunk of time on the clock and the timeouts.
Yeah, not only do they have the timeouts, as you just noted, they're going to get an extra one with the two-minute warning. And that's going to help.
So this one, a victory for the Oakland Raiders. And partner, I must say, good to see you again. Been too long. And it's good to have football back, isn't it?
Didn't you see me in preseason? Weren't we together in preseason?
Yeah, but preseason, you know, it's preseason. This is week one.
Oh, you're trying to say real football.
Yeah, real football.
Not preseason football, yeah. Where we shake down the rosters and figure out who's going to play, and maybe the starters don't play as much. Now it's the frontline guys from the first whistle.
Yeah, I tuned you out in the preseason, and now I'm listening to you.